After I looked at the piano, I saw some pretty obvious problems with the player unit. The hoses were deteriorated to the point of not functioning. All the leather and the rubber cloth and felt was in pretty bad shape. The piano itself was in better shape, but it was a 1927 piano and it still needed a lot of work.
The ivory keyboard had deteriorated at the ends and where they had chipped off and had been hollowed out by the pressure of people's fingers playing. The player unit itself required a complete rebuild. This one has over 100 valves that control different functions from playing the keys to moving the roll. This player system is built on the air logic. As a hole in the roll coincides with a hole in the tracker bar, air enters that hole, travels down a rubber tube to a valve, and it turns it on or turns it off, in which it's connected to a pneumatic, which is either on or off, and it can do whatever work is required. When the air goes through to play a key, the air enters the tracker hole and then travels down through that rubber tube to a primary valve in this system, and then that valve turns on a secondary valve, which provides enough power to collapse a pneumatic. This unit has an electric motor that's hooked into the wall. That electric motor turns a big wheel that is connected to a suction pump that removes air from the pneumatic system, and it goes through a series of hoses to a wind motor, which has a set of 5 sliding valves that open and close. These 5 sliding valves are connected to a crankshaft. The crankshaft turns a wheel through a chain that is connected to the take-up roll on the spool. As that take-up spool rolls, it draws the paper of the player roll across the tracker bar. The holes in the tracker bar then open when the holes in the paper are open. I think the piano should be a viable part of the Villa Philmonte for quite some time to come.